welcome to yet another Babble and Beyond from us, the Bloomz Arthouse. As you know, each month we have one of these fabulous chats with all our artists, or as many of our artists that we can get together in one place in one time, and we have a topic that we discuss for this chat. And there are so many topics that we could discuss regarding art. It's such a huge subject, and there's so many things that affect our art, so many different things personally or in our surroundings. So the topic for today is support, vital when you're talking about art and artists. Breaking with our convention of these chats normally, I'm going to kick this one off, ladies, if that was all right with you.
No. Oh,
yeah.
No.
Oh. That's it. I'm going to go make a cup of tea.
Oh, Sammy, that was uncalled for. The reason I'm kicking this off is that I, for a while, a year or so, I was an independent observer to the Bloomz. Now, the Bloomz, for those of you that aren't familiar, that are watching this, listen to this, that aren't familiar with the Bloomz and how the Bloomz was formed, it was formed out of lockdown, the first lockdown, and it was formed after a group of people, including these fine artists around me here, joined an online course to learn how to sell their art better online, because at the time, of course, there were no art shows. So there were quite a lot of people in this group, and they all shared ideas and found out from the tutors how the best way to go about selling their art online. When the course was over, a number of these artists had gelled so much together that they almost like became Siamese septets or whatever. they were joined at the hip almost by a number of things. And one of those things was the support that this course had generated for between all of these artists. And it was something quite unique. It was something that probably would never have happened had it not been for lockdown, not being for the fact that they were, I wouldn't say forced together, but they came together and realized that they had this within them, this support network, this way of sharing not only their art, but the rest of their lives as well. And I, because Steph, to my this side here, is my partner. Sorry, because it's back to front on Zoom, isn't it, this way? I don't want all of a sudden
in the opposite direction.
Have a lot of trouble from this way if I say this is my part. No, it's not. So Steph over here, was a part of this wonderful group, and of course they weren't called the Bloomz, but when the course was over, a number of them stayed together as friends and art support people, and they became the Bloomz. They decided to form a group called the Bloomz, and that was in recognition of the Bloomsbury Group, which was a group of artists, philosophers, authors, back at the turn of the 20th century, when they used to get together and talk about all sorts of things to do with their various arts in Bloomsbury Square in London. So it was great that they called themselves the Bloomz. And I was very fortunate because I was dragged into helping out in various ways by Steph. I then had the unique honour.
I don't remember it that way. I remember someone standing in the back going, can I help?
All right. I could see what a wonderful support group this was and decided to lend my few humble skills to helping them out. So I became an associate member. Now, I pause there because the website say that I'm an ass. That's Steph's idea. It stands for associate. So I witnessed firsthand the wonderful support that the artists had for each other. It's not just particular to the Bloomz, I'm sure. Artists all around the country, all around the world, have got great support for their artists. Doesn't always happen. There are some instances, and we all know them, where people aren't so supportive. But it's the sharing of ideas, the support through the good times, the trials and tribulations of being an artist, that I noticed was amazing within the Bloomz. It just shone and it has stayed. And of course, one or two people left because of various reasons. So we're now left with a core Bloomz of seven members and an arse. and it's just brilliant. So I've seen the support. I've seen the way that you welcome me into your clutches. Is that the word?
You felt obliged.
And have supported me. Have supported me in my art, but the way that you constantly, on a day-to-day basis, support each other and other artists that aren't a member of the Bloomz, when you see people posting things on the Facebook groups and Instagram groups that somebody has maybe a little bit of imposter syndrome or they're struggling with something, you are the first people to jump in and give your support, free support. You share your ideas, you share your techniques, and it has been wonderful to watch. So from my point of view, I have benefited both directly and indirectly from the support that I've seen going through the Bloomz group. And I'm sure that each one of you will have your own stories of how the Bloomz and other artists that you've met along the way over the years and family members have supported you through your art. That wasn't too long, was it, Sammy? Oh, stop. I thought I'd just kick off because that really sets the scene for our chat this morning, in that we are going to hear from each of these lovely ladies about, and because Sammy was so forthright there in jumping in, you can go first down there. What a support me to you, Sammy. I will sit back, have my cup of tea. What a support me to you as an artist.
Okay, so you know, I'm teasing. I'm absolutely teasing. You know, what you said is right, Steve. You know, you got it. You got all the little nuggets out there for everyone to understand how we work as a group. I'd just like to say that prior to becoming part of the Bloomz, I was working very much on my own, and I thought I was doing okay. You know, I was selling work, I was creating work, but being part of this group elevated my work to another level, because of the generosity of all the other artists with their feedback, with how they work, with their processes and everything, sort of like snaffle bits from here, there and everywhere to cause my work to then go to a different level. Prior to the Bloomz, when I was seeing other artists online and trying to engage with them, they were very polite and everything, but they never shared. Mm-hmm. So this is what is very different with the Bloomz, is that we are all very open and more than happy to share our processes, which you will find other artists will not do. So there may be, you may belong to, say, for example, the Watercolour Society or the Acrylics or whatever, Oil Painting Society, and you will find that you're along with similar people because you all have a similar interest, but you'll be very hard pushed to find someone that actually is willing to share with you what they do, how they do it, and how they'd love you to have a go at doing it too.
Is that born out of insecurity, you think, for these other artists that think you're going to somehow steal their ideas, do better than them? Because it's not a competition, is it?
It's not a competition, but I think people see it like that. A lot of artists do see it like, well, if I tell you, you're going to go and do that. Well, someone may do a technique similar to what I do, but it's never going to be the same. Yeah. And it's never going to be my work. And
I mean, if we all did the same thing, it still wouldn't be the same, would it? If we all said, right, everyone's going to do this thing and we're all going to do it in acrylics and we're all going to use the same skills that we've been taught, it would all still look completely different, because the great thing about an artist is we all put our interpretation on it, don't we, if nothing else. And so a Sammy is always going to be completely different to anything that I'm going to produce. So, yeah, absolutely. So it is a kind of insecurity.
I think it's a lack mindset. They're afraid that there's not enough buyers out there. If they show us their process or whatever, and we create work that might come out something along the similar ideas of what they're doing, maybe the buyers will come to us instead of them, and they won't have any buyers. I think it's got to do with stuff like that as well. Mm.
But an artist wouldn't want, if you were doing, if you were being shown another process, that, oh, I'll use that process, you wouldn't want your art then to be the same as the person. Okay, I'm going to use that.
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
Absolutely. But that's where, you know, sorry, I'm sorry we're interjecting on Sammy's.
There's enough during the day anyway.
So. That's the thing in the group here. It's not that we just share. It's not like someone says and we go, oh, yeah, I'll give you this piece of knowledge. It's a gladly love everybody. And the moment someone comes back and says, I did that you showed me, it's like, brilliant. Love the fact that someone else was able to actually do something with that. It's a joy that comes from that, not a begrudgingly sharing of something. You know, exactly. If I have to show you that. Yeah. Sorry,
but,
Sammy.
But
sorry.
When you were saying again about supporting other artists, it's on a Friday on my page, on my Instagram and social media pages, I support other artists. It's called Artists Supporting Artists. So I follow a lot of artists, and as well as highlighting the girls in the Blooms and yourself, Steve, I also follow other artists, and so I'll pull them up and I will email them first and say, do you mind? No one has yet said no. And because I just want some, I want other people to see what I enjoy as well as an artist, because as an artist, to have other people's artwork in your home is that's just a beautiful thing to have, because a lot of people think, well, artists don't buy other artists' work. Well, you do.
Well,
yeah. We've had the experience of being at art fairs and people go, oh, you're an artist, and they won't really engage with you. You sort of think, well, I could have bought your work, but I'm not going to now. You know, so it is about finding that the world is open to everyone. And I was saying to an artist this morning that, as we all believe, every piece of art we create that we're putting up for sale, there is a person that's going to buy it. They just haven't seen it yet. So don't think your work isn't good enough, because it is. That person that's going to buy it just hasn't seen it yet. That's it. That's all I have to say.
Yeah. No, that's actually true, because when you do a show and sometimes you take pieces that people haven't looked at or something that you don't particularly like or whatever, and you sort of had it... And you go there, and then suddenly three people come up and want to buy it. And you think, what? And it's like, that's it. Because the people are there. They just haven't seen it before. And there's nothing, I say, we have emotions about our own work. But always the bit, the one that I think is damaged or I did something wrong with, that's always the one which sells first. It's hilarious. Because what I like and what other people like is a completely different thing, you know. So, yeah.
But doesn't it also feel nice within yourself when you help another artist?
That feeling
you get, you know, you've helped somebody. I mean, I'm constantly getting people DM me on Instagram asking how I put a touch sensor switch on a lamp. And one of them the other week wanted to know how I did the tail on my dog lamp and from the tap. And I must have spent about an hour and a half with diagrams that I'd annotated and sent to them. And I didn't at one moment think, I don't want him copying this. And he was just starting up, I think he was over in the States, just starting up doing lamp making. But he's no threat to me. And even if I thought he was going to make the lamp and sell it, good luck to him. But it gave me a lot of pleasure, that time I spent helping somebody out. Because I know how much pleasure I get from my art. And to think that somebody else, with a little bit of help, a little bit of advice, enthusiasm, you know, will get just as much enjoyment from doing it.
I think the moment you stop giving is the moment you stop receiving.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely, yeah. And there's the great thing about the Blooms, yes, we did come from, we went on a commercial course and we met, and everybody on the course started in the Blooms, and then it just slowly whittled down to the core, which it's always going to do. That, you know, that's just the way of life. But we've now, you know, we are a brilliant support, not just for art, but for everything. You know, we have our safe space now, that when we come into a Blooms group, it's just a safe space, which is why it has to be a closed group. And while we're not sort of like opening up and having other people join, because we just, we have had a life together. And it'd be quite difficult to include somebody else, which is why we do have associate members. But, you know, whatever we say, they were never. But that's not a negative. But you can go and pay to join, you know, other groups and get support. But you're still signing up to a lot of rules. We have no rules. We can say, we can cry, we can laugh. As you've probably noticed, we take the mickey out of each other because we are quite secure in the fact that we love each other dearly and it comes from a place of love and nowhere else. And it's just that is so precious. And you can't join a paid group to get that. So anybody who has a chance of knitting together with some people that you feel, you know, you see it around, don't you? You think, oh, that group have definitely gelled together, and you can see how, but you always know that's them. And but if you can find your group of people, it's just, there's nothing like it.
Because that's what I like the fact that you ladies have got your own core Bloomz group on Messenger group that you can chat amongst yourselves, which is fine. I really haven't got the time to spend doing that. But I've got a messenger group called the Bloomz Girls, which includes me as well. So I get to chip in and have a little bit of fun. But Steph just said, it is all about humour. I think today, in today's world, humour plays a very important part in keeping us all sane. If you haven't got humour, if you can't raise a smile each day for something, and, you know,
it's... keeps your vibrations up. Those vibrations up, you know. We were saying yesterday that process or the item which we loved from the Joanna Hunter thing was the dancing, you know, the singing and dancing. And that just gets your vibrations up, doesn't it? If you're feeling a bit down, you think, what is it I want? Just create a song. And in our case, we dance around the gondola in the kitchen.
Got an island in the kitchen. We can do it a lot better now that we're on a healthy eating.
It's a bit more moving. The hips not breaking as I'm going round, you know.
I think there's a part of support that we need to talk about, which Steph and I are very fortunate because there are only the two of us here. That's fortunate. We don't have anybody else here. But there are only the two of us here, which means we can support each other. So family support is very important, isn't it, when we are. So how does that affect the rest of you, family support? Who wants to...
I get a huge amount of support and encouragement from my other half. He's always encouraging me. You know, he'll look at my work and say if he likes it or not, or what he thinks of it, which normally, luckily, he does like it, which is good. But, you know, I would far rather that he supports me genuinely and says, yeah, what is it? Or what, you know, rather than just saying, oh, that's lovely. Because just saying that isn't helpful, you know, if he doesn't think that. So, but I say, luckily he does like what I do generally. So that's, you know, and that support is so important, being given the time and space to get on and create and not have somebody keep coming in, oh, are you nearly finished?
Oh, you still doing that?
He does like his cups of tea, but apart from that, you know, he will bring me tea as well. So so I think that is really important. And the times that he's been with me when I've been painting outside on plein air, he just reads a book or whatever he wants to do, and not once has he ever said, how's it going, or are you nearly done yet, or times, you know, until I'm done, that's it. He is so supportive in that respect. I think the support, this was some midnight musings last night. You know, we've got the support of each other in this group, which has already been talked about and is absolutely fantastic. We know we can share things, you know, whether that's, oh, I found this wonderful app that allows you to do so and so, or this program or this whatever, or new materials, or having a play with this, it's great fun. You know, I got some new art supplies yesterday and I thought, oh, you can't see it, some glazing medium light for improving translucency and flow of oil paint for detail work and stuff. And
I just thought, your word for that's not alcohol.
Not sure I want to drink that. It looks rather like something.
but, any points in storm, Fiona?
Finding a new product, having a go with it, if I think it's great, you know, it'll be like, oh, you know, not that any of you generally use oils much, Julie a bit with your encaustic, but, you know, or if I found or read something somewhere about fibre sculpting, needle felting, you know, for Steph, you know, oh, have you read about this the other day? Have you seen that? Or do you know about that? You know, and it's sharing, supporting, caring, motivating, inspiring. But we've also got support from families, as you were just saying, which I'm very lucky. I have a lot of support. Support from other artists, with Sammy and her artist supporting artist. And, you know, I try to share quite a few other people's posts to my story, you know, share, you know, spread the word. But also from the public, you know, people that on social media, if they see our posts, they can help support us absolutely free by liking or commenting. It all helps to, you know, the algorithm to send our work out to more people so that more people see what we're doing. And at, say, art fairs, you know, as Sammy said, artists do buy other artists' work. So, you know, and even if you don't think they'll buy your work, you're networking, you're making connections, you're building relationships, and that's valuable in itself. It's not a competition, as we've said. If somebody likes my work or Sammy's work, no effort on either of our part is going to convince them that they like the other person's work better than the person's work that they like. So it's not a competition. You know, you just do the best you can and stay true to yourself. But also there, and I know at the moment a lot of people are still concerned about finances and that, but just buying a single card is still helping to support. If everybody that came through the show bought one card, that adds up to a lot of help and support for artists, you know. So I think support in terms of art and creativity comes from so many different
And it also, it's also, you just touched on there when you mentioned the cards. A lot of artists have other strings to their bow that are connected with their art, but sometimes in order to adapt to situations around the world, the financial situations, or maybe you decided to go a different direction, changing what you do with your art a little bit can lend you to needing more support. I'm going to go with Julie here because Julie's done just that. She's moved not away from encaustic painting, but you're bringing in photography into that. So that's been a change in your art. And what sort of support have you needed to be able to do that and not worry that was it the right direction to go in?
Well, to be honest, the photography side just works so nicely because I can just run it parallel to both. Currently, having just moved, I haven't got a studio set up yet, so I don't need the studio. But so I've been doing smartphone photography. We've all got these smartphones we're going around with. Most people have no idea. They point the camera, they go photo, click, and away. They haven't got any idea what else is on there. And I've teamed up with a lady. In fact, she used to be at my first studio. So when I first, and that, I could go down so many rabbit holes with support. There's so many different facets of support that you can go down. But when I got my first ever studio, we had, I think we were about, always between 15 and 20 different artists there. All had our own studios. It was like a collective. And it was amazing because we would all just, you know, you left each other alone enough to get on and create your own work. But equally, you'd pop in and have a cuppa sometimes, or you'd, you know, pop in and out. What are you up to today then? Oh, I'm just having a break for 5 minutes. I'm tired, you know. And just by talking to them, you would be so energized. But the lady that runs the smartphone, she was a full-time photographer, or with her, you know, full-on cameras, but the cameras are so good on smartphones now that she's given up all of that, and she has purely gone down the smartphone photography route. But she used to be in the studio downstairs for me. So you're going back to networks, you're saying about connections, you're building networks, we just gelled. We got on like a house on fire, and it just worked out brilliantly. She was in Hertfordshire. I've moved to Cornwall. She had nobody in Cornwall running these safaris that she runs. So, what do you think that could work? Brilliant. So, you know, and but it just works in such, it just sits alongside what I'm doing with my encaustic so nicely. And then there's a technique called photo encaustic, so I can combine the two. But, you know, there's just that, oh, there's so many facets of support, there really are. And I just find it turns out to be like a bit of a spider's web. It's an absolute mesh, and, you know, one person, there's so many different areas. So, yeah.
Mm.
You know,
but it all cross-pollinates, doesn't it?
As in, absolutely, yeah, yeah. It's like a whole safety net of like people that are, you know, and I just think people come in and out of your life at the right times, you know. And going back to just being generous with your information as well, you know, I try and pack in as much information as I can to, you know, I don't want to kind of only go and give one or two tips and then they might come back. Or I want to absolutely overload and share as much as I can. And I've always been like that. I only really started painting and drawing in 2011. And what encouraged me into it is I met a lady, in fact, it was a local church bazaar that I was at. She said, oh, come along to our art club. And I was like, I think it's important actually to find a network where you do have like a set area of time as well. Where, so I'd go, you know, 2 hours on a Friday, and I would just look forward to those 2 hours every week. And you know, you start off and you're like, oh, I don't think I'm going to go. No, I'm not going to go. And then you go and you're like, that was amazing. Why was I? But again, so supportive. And they were just, you know, next week they'd bring in some pastels, try these. And next week, it would be, you know, what about these? And again, just so generous with their information. And I just see it as a paying forward kind of approach, you know. And that encouraged me to get into my art fully. That's when I got my first art studio, you know. And if I hadn't had that support and I'd been met with this, like, you know, I just wouldn't have carried on with it. So I think it's important to nurture people and to, you know, just to support and encourage as much, even just encouragement. And I think it's important to be in a like-minded group of people that actually get what you do as well. Family support is brilliant, but personally, for my family, we haven't got any artists or anybody that paints themselves. So whilst they are really supportive in terms of time, and I think actually being involved with somebody that can paint as well, and particularly with Encaustic, when I went to the Encaustic conference last year, to be in a room of people that actually knew even what it was. I mean, it's remarkable. Most people go, oh, that's nice. And you spend most of your time explaining what it is rather than, but, you know, to be in a room of people that actually know what it is and they're as enthusiastic about it as you are is quite something. So I think there's sort of different facets of support. There's family support, there's people that encourage and share ideas, and there's people that really, you know, they know what you do. And
And Fiona's mentioned about support from the public as well. But there's one side of support we haven't covered, and I'm going to go over to Cindy for this, because it is a very unique and very special sort of support, and that's the spiritual support that you, okay, you're amongst us here, you're our spiritual guru for this. I see that as a form of support as well. Am I right in thinking? Was that Henry there or Cleo?
That one was Cleo, and Henry is now coming in.
Henry.
You can't tell me that is... You can't tell me that isn't support.
Yeah.
That's lots of support.
Tell us a little bit about the support you get from the spiritual side.
There's just a lot of comfort in your spiritual connection when you're really connected in and, how do you explain? Comfort is the best word I can use. You just feel... constantly feel much happier, much more at peace, much more relaxed, and everything is just much easier. Like things that once upon a time would have been a big drama, as you yourself and Steph know at the moment with things that have been going on personally with you guys, you just, when you're spiritually connected, it's just so much easier. It's like it doesn't faze you anymore. It does those normal stresses that of everyday life don't throw you. They don't disrupt your flow. They don't disrupt your mood. All those sorts of things. It's a big support.
be a great support to you also, because of course your other half, he's away quite a lot, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Days on end. But
yes,
you mentioned the word comfort there. That must, to have the spiritual side helping you there, and the light that you bring, the light energy that you bring into your art as well. And I know from you guiding me to find my spirit animal, just how much Henry is a part of that whole process. You know, we could, well, we are going to have a month where we do the spiritual side of art. So I don't want to sort of steal any of your thunder here, but I mean, that's it must really help you to have that when Bill's away and you're struggling with a piece of art, all of a sudden you get those vibes come through.
I was going to say, it's funny because I don't tend to struggle with pieces of art anymore.
Ooh. Well, that's
can fine. I say that? I haven't found myself struggling at all anymore, like for a long time. I can't think of the last time I got really stuck.
So is that because of the spiritual side of it, do you think? Is that why you're not struggling? Is it just flows? Yeah,
it just flows. Yeah, you just go with the flow, and so you don't get that stuck or that block or anything like I used to get a lot. So yeah, I don't find that anymore. I just go with it. If I do hesitate to do anything, I can literally just stop and meditate for a few minutes and I'm right back there and there's no problem whatsoever.
Yeah. We found recently, because we've just embarked in the last 12 months on meditation and all that, the same sort of thing, but only at a, not as an advanced level as you probably are, Cindy, but we are getting there. But it really helps. It's a great support to us. As you said, we're going through this awful, well, it's not an awful situation. It's a frustrating situation some days of trying to move house. And we're just on, hopefully this weekend, on our fourth buyer. We found that we can give ourselves support. If we didn't have each other to bounce off, and, you know, because there are days that we're a little bit down and the other ones a little bit up.
Sometimes, like the situation we've got now with regards to the house and everything, it's actually given us the opportunity, because you have definitely come more towards the meditation and you found the person you like very much, Mike, who you listen to. And like yesterday, you sat down and afterwards you were like, yes, that's it. I feel like I'm in a really good place now after listening to that. If we hadn't had this year where you weren't able to go down to your studio and actually create anything because it's in storage, you've actually had the time to do these things. And sometimes, as much as we go, well, this is a bit painful, feel a little bit like, you know, we're in the middle of nowhere, but it's actually given you that opportunity to go and find that different support. And actually within this group, as I say, we kind of Cindy with her spiritual, Mac as well, who's not here, you know, with the kind of completely different ways, everybody finds a different voice. Some people you know, don't want that much support from that side, and some people want a lot of support, but we can all go, oh, actually, I found someone who talks about that kind of thing. You might want to go and listen to them and things. And so that's where we get the old cross-pollination in here about all that as well. And once again, you know, nothing is thrust upon you. You know, someone's beliefs might be different to yours, and that's absolutely fine. But I do think that this year has given us the opportunity to grow in that sense, rather than it being
supported. It supported our mind in particular, because I can't do anything at the moment because all my stuff's in store, as Steph just said. But doing what I've been doing with the Silver Method, with Mike Dooley and his creative visualization and manifestation and all that, it's really is supporting my art before I even start doing it again, because I've got great ideas and ways that I'm going to approach it. So that's a different sort of support. And the support that we have, Steph, for each other when we're making pieces is quite useful, as critical as we are with each other. But it's a constructive criticism born out of love, I hope. Because
the thing is, we do have a very, very honest relationship anyway, don't we? So there's no way that when it comes to our art, we're suddenly going to go, oh, that's lovely. As Fiona says, how useful is that? Oh, that's lovely. Yeah. You know, when you actually want someone to say, you know, like you'll say to me, so you haven't finished it yet. And I think, oh, fuck, haven't I?
We'll bleep that out. No, I'll say to you, you'll present me with a piece, and I'll say, "The ear's not, it's the ear's fine." You'll say, "The ear's absolutely fine." And then about an hour later, you'll come in sheepishly. I've redone the ear. But that's the way it is. You're a little bit, you know, blunter when it comes to my pieces. I did a rock singer that you thought looked like a what do you call it?
A twirling majorette. He said, "What's this?" I said, "Is it a majorette?" And he goes, "Oh, God, it's not a majorette."
And of course, all I could see when I looked at the draft was the drum majorette. So I had to make some alterations too. But you know, that's the difference. But that's support.
Also, people, you get to know, because like I always know, you walk into the room and you'll say, "So this is fine. I've done this, and this part of it is absolutely fine. So what do you think?" And of course, obviously, he doesn't think it's fine, and that's why he's actually come in and he's like, "I'm telling you now, you need to tell me this bit's fine." And I go, "Oh, that bit, really? You really think it's fine?" And he's like, "No."
Yeah, but ultimately, to get some feedback is good from other people around you, because often we can be close to what we're doing and we sometimes miss the little bits that other people think, "Well, that's not quite right. Has he really thought, or has she really thought about that a bit?" Because we see sometimes just what we want to see. We're doing a particular...
One of the things we did in the group here, if you remember, it was a while ago now, where we actually looked at each other's art and said what each other's art... how we would describe each other's art, because we said when you go to a show and you sell your work and you go, "Oh yes, you know, and I've done this and I've done that," you think, "Oh, that person didn't seem that interested. Oh, okay." And then someone else can say to you, "Well, why didn't you tell them about this and this?" And you think, "Well, I didn't realize they'd be interested in that." And it was really useful for us to actually say, "Well, this is the part." And it's like I often use the word stabbing when it comes to doing my creations, and it was one of the things I think Fiona very first said, you know, "It's not actually an attractive word, Steph, to use when you know and it isn't, and it actually doesn't describe the action at all." And in fact, I'm creating some new videos now and I am deliberately not using the word stab, because it actually implies incorrectly that you're going, you know, which you're more likely to actually stab yourself because you're frantic for them. The things like that where you go, "Oh yeah, everybody else actually uses that word, but why should I use the word that everybody else uses? I need to start using different." And so that's really, really useful to find how someone else would describe your work.
You haven't found a word to replace it though, have you?
Do I? I have actually. No, I have now. I've now described it as, because it depends if you're doing pushing the needle in and out, where you're doing a strong felt, or whether you're tapping it on top when you're doing a light felt. So that's what I describe it as now. So, there you go.
Right. Well, I think we've covered support in all its many facets really well today. Thank you very much, all you lovely ladies, for joining me this morning and telling us a little bit about your support that you get. We can, of course, always accept more support from other artists if you're watching this.
All support, welcome.
Yeah. We will always support you without a shadow of a doubt. If you're an artist watching this and you want some support with what you're doing, you're not sure about something, we have most of the arts areas covered by the people in the Bloomz. If you're a member of the public and you're thinking, "Maybe I want to start doing a piece of art, maybe I've never done art before and I want to start, where do I go to get a little bit of support?" Here. We're here.
Or even a member of the public wanting to know a little bit more about how do they start investing in art? I don't mean for an investment as such, but how do they start collecting art? Yeah. What should they be looking for? And, you know, in my view, that's buy art that you love because you want to live with it every day. But, you know, if they've got questions, how do I hang the work? Where should I put it? And, you know, they can ask any of us.
What should I ask when I speak to an artist? Because I think it can be quite scary, can't it? About should I just know this stuff? Or can I just ask the artist, like, "This is my first piece, my first investment in art. Tell me about it," you know.
There's no such thing as a stupid question, apart from the one that isn't asked.
What you're not going to get from any of the Bloomz, if you're asking us about how should I start collecting art, you're not going to get us trying to sell you our art. You might not be into oil paintings with Fiona, for instance, or acrylics or abstract art, but we might know somebody who does that sort of art that we can, well, they're best to advise you, but I bought a piece of this sort of art and this is what I look for. So don't think when you talk to an artist, the first thing they're going to do is to sell you their art. They might be, but if they're really good artists and they care about you as a potential collector, they're going to open up and show you different areas of art that you might be interested in. Because once you start loving art and you're getting support to appreciate all different sorts of art, then everything is open to you to ask, to buy, and to enjoy. And that's what we're all here for, is to support each other, support our buyers, support other artists, and enjoy and get so much passion from what we do. And each month you'll find another topic, another group of artists, some of the same old faces will raise their heads, I'm sure. And we there's only eight of us, so you're going to get most of us each time anyway. Enjoy yourself, enjoy finding out about art, and join the Bloomz Art House next month. So from us all here, it's goodbye for now. Bye.
Bye. Bye.